How the organ system of representative animals relate to each other, and what are the relationships and its functions of this organ system? Target is to identify the different organ system of a representative animals and describe the characteristics and functions of these organ systems and explain the functional relationship each organ system. And what are the organs of a representative animals? One of it is digestive system. What is digestive system and what is the function of this organ? The digestive system is a complex and vital organ system of a representative animals which is responsible for breaking down of food into nutrients that the body can absorb food, energy growth, and repair. It is a long tube that runs from your mouth to your anus. An organ which is responsible to digest every food you intake in your mouth, which process all the nutrients that come from the food. What about breathing? What system, organ system, is responsible in breathing? And that organ is what we call respiratory system. Gas exchange is very important among animals by respiratory system, as they require oxygen in the production of higher amount of energy compared to the process of energy production without oxygen. How does it works? The air flowing through the respiratory system is also warm to body temperatures and saturated with water. As it respirates, it includes lungs and all structures that moves air to and from the lungs. The respiratory tract is lined with cilia to filter the debris and dust. Another thing, the upper respiratory tract consists of three structures. What are these? Nasal cavities and the interconnected sinuses, the pharynx, and the larynx. The respiratory system tract consists of respiratory tree, the trachea, the bronchioles, and alveoli. Now, through digestion, the nutrients coming from the food, which is intake, is absorbed and transported by circulation. So, which is the main function of this organ system, the circulatory system. There are different ways in which animals transport substance across their body. But in animals with closed circulatory system, the circulatory fluid does not go out of the vessel. Exchange occurs through diffusion via thinner vessels called capillaries across interstitial fluid. For an organism to circulate the system, basically it involves the pumping of the heart's fluid through the organism. In an open circulatory system, a tubular heart pumps hemolymph through channels and cavities throughout the body. However, in a closed circulatory system, a closed circulatory or a cardiovascular includes a strong heart and blood vessels. The heart pumps the blood to the body and receives the blood returned to the heart. But not all animals have the same process of circulation. Different animals have adopted different mechanisms for transport, such as in fishes where a single circulation is enough. Compared to cetaceans, the gastrovascular cavity of flatworms have extension in order to reach areas of the body far from the axis. Amphibians, however, have a double circulation differs from mammalian. Another important organ system of a representative animals is the urinary system. How does it works? So urinary system is very important. Why? In order to remove waste, a representative animals have the excretory system, which enables it to remove excess salt or water in the body. Waste removal follow this process: filtration, reabsorption, secretion, and excretion. Organisms have different waste in the form of nitrogenous waste, which they need to excrete. Different organisms have different excretory system, such as protonepridia or flatworms, and so on and so forth. To defend the internal environment of representative animals, immune system is very important. The immune system provides cells that aid in protection of the body from disease via the antigen or antibody response. A variety of general response are also part of this system. That's why it is very important to protect our immune system. What about endocrine system? What is the function of this organ system to representative animals? The endocrine system involves the gland that secrete the body's hormones into bloodstream. The endocrine system works with the nervous system to provide homeostasis in the body. The nervous system, the central, is composed of brain and spinal cord, and it works through or by processing and transmitting messages which convey for appropriate response. Now, what about you want to be sexy? You want to be masculine? What organ system is being developed in this? And we call that a muscular system. A muscular system, an organized muscles from its largest structure to its functional unit as a repeating longitudinal structure that is bound together. The contraction possible or is possible because of the structural organization of protein molecules that makes up the sarcomere. When contraction occurs, the sarcomere shortens, and this is reflected in the contraction of the muscle. Now, what is the importance or significance of the skeletal system? The skeletal system provides support and protection and attachment points for every muscle of representative animals. The skeletal system provides a rigid framework for movement. It supports and protects the body and every body parts, produces blood cells, and stores minerals. We have different bones which our muscles can pull to create movement, and the different types of joints are responsible for different movement that our body can create. A representative animal consists of various organ and system which connected and interact each other, each of which contains several specific organs and functions. An organ is a unique anatomic structure consisting a group of tissue that work in concert to perform specific functions.